Hot out of the box, the newest entry into America's quest to dominate air combat. This is everything we know about America's 6th-gen stealth fighter, the F-47. Not content to merely match or even surpass projected enemy capabilities, the Air Force had a more ambitious goal in mind. With the rise of China in the Pacific and the growing certainty of a future conflict in the region, the U.S. set out to absolutely outclass any competitor, anywhere in the world, and reclaim the Air Force's uncontested dominance of the skies. But before even a single one is actually built, the F-47 may already be more disaster than triumph. The White House's unveiling of the F-47 received a great deal of fanfare, and the story was soon picked up around the globe. After years of extreme secrecy, the world was finally getting a peek at America's next-generation air superiority fighter. But more importantly, it was proof that the U.S. was actually going to build one in the first place. The story behind the scenes of the Air Force's NGAD program hasn't exactly been harmonious or even happy. Launched back in 2014, NGAD set out to deliver an aircraft that would carry on America's post-World War II legacy of air dominance in every conflict it enters. NGAD's general goal seemed a pretty straightforward one – more stealth, more weapons, more range, better sensors. The NGAD was initially seen as merely another step along a largely linear progression in fighter aircraft, one that first prioritized maneuverability, then stealth and long-range detection with the F-22. It was basically going to be more of the same. And then the drone revolution happened and everything changed. NGAD was always foreseen to operate alongside drone wingmen, even from the earlier days of design work. But as the years passed, the relationship between NGAD, now the F-47, and drones changed dramatically. At first, drones were simply meant to augment the F-47's capabilities, providing extra support while the fighter took the lead. But as AI advanced and air defenses became increasingly lethal, the role of drones began to shift. Suddenly, they weren't just supporting the mission, they were taking on part of the F-47's traditional mission. One might handle target sensing, allowing the F-47 to stay hidden and undetected. Another could be tasked with firing weapons, engaging targets without ever putting the manned fighter directly in harm's way. In the last 2 years, though, lessons learned from the war in Ukraine and the ongoing drone revolution started raising some very difficult questions. What was the F-47's role in the drone air fleet going to be exactly? Because even before a design had been chosen for the F-47, the Air Force was quite clear on one thing. Air Force leaders wanted at least 1,000 drones in their inventory alongside the F-47. The problem with the F-47 was that even as costs for the manned aircraft were increasing, drones were becoming more capable and cheaper. At one point, the F-47 was projected to have a cost of around $300 million and a price point comparable to that of a stealth bomber, or at least half of one, as the B-21 is projected to cost over $700 million per unit. And with costs ballooning to stealth bomber levels, many in the Air Force started asking an important question: why even build a fighter in the first place? Let's hope they got the answer right, because if not, the U.S. is set to lose the very first war the F-47 enters. Increasing lethality of air defenses very quickly made it clear that any 6th-gen fighter would have to prioritize stealth to the extreme. And that means losing traditional fighter design features specifically optimized for maneuverability and extreme speeds. Design features like a standing tail, for one. Whatever form NGAD ultimately took, one thing was clear from the start: it wouldn't look like a traditional fighter. Instead, it would resemble something closer to a stealth bomber, trading the ability to pull off dogfighting maneuvers for the ability to see first and shoot first at long range. Then there's the requirement for greatly extended range. In 2024, officials within the U.S. Department of Defense finally said out loud what many Pentagon insiders had been whispering for years: the homeland is no longer a sanctuary. In the future, adversary weapon systems will have the ability to strike at targets inside the U.S. with ease. Even today, China has an anti-access area denial bubble around the South China Sea that keeps U.S. carriers hundreds of miles away from a fight. That means future fighters will have to launch from airfields far outside the reach of these threats, which means more internal volume for fuel. To do that, they'll need massively increased range and a total rethink of traditional fighter design. So if you're prioritizing range and stealth over traditional fighter attributes, why build a fighter in the first place? That was the question that rocked the NGAD program and almost brought it to a full stop. For a while, the Air Force even considered simply purchasing more B-21 Raiders over the F-47. The B-21 is rumored to have the capability to launch air-to-air missiles and engage enemy fighters. But there were additional design questions that last year did bring NGAD to a pause. With drones becoming an increasingly vital part of the F-47 system and their capabilities advancing rapidly, some began to question the wisdom of having an expensive manned aircraft in the first place. Why not just go all drone? In May 2024, Air Force Secretary Frank Kendall went on a ride inside an experimental F-16. The flight itself was rather ordinary, except for one crucial detail: there was no human at the controls. The F-16 was being piloted by an AI that the Air Force had been teaching to fly aircraft in the real world. It has also undergone real-world dogfighting exercises against human opponents. The Air Force's achievements in putting an AI in a real cockpit and having it fly simulated combat missions successfully, even showing a degree of autonomy, led many to question whether the F-47 should even be manned in the first place. The B-21 is already coming with the ability to optionally man, and perhaps the F-47 will too. But many in the Air Force were pushing for a fully drone fleet. Forget the human fighter pilots. The reason why is simple. China is not quite a pacing threat, but they are a very close one, and new offensive weapon systems are incredibly expensive, while defensive systems are becoming cheaper, smarter, and more effective. This is a recipe for financial ruin. If your $300 million fighter is getting downed by an AI-enabled million-dollar air defense missile, well, that's not a war you're gonna win. So many called for the Air Force to simply go backwards in time, not forwards, in preparation for the next great war. Rather than field a small fleet of exquisite aircraft, like the 150 or so combat-coded F-22s currently in service, many now argue the Air Force should field a massive fleet of capable aircraft. Cheap, expendable, and extremely numerous drones would be seen as overwhelming enemy air defense networks. As long as each drone was kept at a cost of around $3 million or so a pop, the U.S. would come out ahead in the economic war as well. And this is where we get to the announcement of the F-47, a move that actually surprised many in the defense world. It seems the White House made a bet that the F-47 would be a winner, but there is a serious concern that they bet wrong. In summer of 2024, the Air Force officially announced that it was putting the NGAD program on pause. The decision had been long rumored and based on all the difficulties in predicting what next-generation air warfare will be like. Simply put, technology is moving so fast that betting on the wrong concept today will spell defeat tomorrow. Unlike air fleets of the past, the F-47 is going to be such an exquisite piece of machinery that it will take years to replace combat losses, not months like in World War II. If the White House has bet wrong on the F-47 and the future of air combat, the U.S. Air Force could be in serious trouble. Consider this: during World War II, a P-51 Mustang could be built in just 2 to 3 weeks. In the Cold War, the F-4 Phantom took about 4 to 6 months, the F-15 needed 3 to 4 months, and the modern F-35 takes 18 months to produce. And that is during peacetime. In a future conflict, U.S.-based production facilities could be under attack from enemy drones and long-range missile strikes, stretching those timelines even further. The pattern is obvious. If the White House miscalculated what the F-47 should be, then it is a strategic failure. First is the speed of the announcement for the F-47 itself, which caught many by surprise. 6 months before its announcement, the Air Force had put the entire NGAD program on pause. Then suddenly it's all ready to go, all in on a specific design. Many feared that the new White House administration rushed into the decision, forcing the Air Force's hand, merely for the good PR that the announcement of the F-47 would generate. Then there's the added pressure from China, which a few months prior to the F-47's announcement had released images of two suspected next-gen aircraft already flying. The combination of political pressure and a desire to create headlines could have forced a poor decision on the F-47, making it a flawed design right out of the gate, or even a flat-out wrong one. Details on the F-47 naturally remain incredibly secret, but there is some critical info on the plane through what has been announced. We know the F-47 is likely set to be a record-breaking aircraft. We just don't know what the records are exactly. After flights of two X-planes related to the NGAD program in 2019 and 2022, the U.S. Air Force announced that they had broken multiple long-standing records, but declined to comment on which records exactly. While nobody knows what the F-47 looks like yet, at least no one who's telling, we were treated to some concept art. There are some interesting things that we can learn from this. First, right up front, is the fact that the F-47 appears to have canards. It's no secret that canards do not make for an optimally stealthy plane. They add new surfaces which radar signals can bounce off of, and make signature management on the whole more difficult. This is why, since the J-20 was publicly revealed, Western commenters have often snubbed the Chinese 5th-gen fighter by pointing at the canards. China's J-20 makes use of canards to enhance its maneuverability, indicating that the Chinese aren't as confident as the U.S. in their see-first, shoot-first capabilities. and expect their fighters to get into the merge more often than U.S. stealth fighters. It's believed that the F-47 will feature canards for much the same reason, which once more brings a host of questions about the decisions to move forward with the project after it was put on pause. If the Air Force still believes that the F-47 needs to be maneuverable, then why go with an expected tailless design in the first place? Is the F-47 truly the design that next-generation warfare needs? We don't know the answers to these questions, but what we do know is that no concept art of the NGAD ever featured canards, making them a surprising addition to what's expected to be a close-to-final design. And while it's a myth that canards destroy stealth characteristics, they do have a significant impact depending on the observing angle. However, the F-47 employing canards is not a stealth-optimal design, bringing into question the entirety of the design. But there may be more to those canards than appears at first sight. It's been theorized that the canards themselves may be fully retractable, allowing the F-47 to pull them into an internal housing when not needed. There's also the possibility that the canards are fixed and not maneuverable, existing only to help provide lift during a certain part of the flight envelope. Either would help with managing the loss of stealth, with fully retractable canards being the best option. However, given the danger of adding complexity to a design, retractable canards are unlikely to be a feature. The next thing we can tell from the concept art is that the F-47 will have a more sophisticated suite of avionics than any other fighter before it. The wide, flat nose is perfect for housing powerful radars and other cutting-edge avionics. This is in line with the expected operational use of the F-47, not as a maneuverable fighter near the front lines, but as a long-range sniper using drone wingmen to close the gap. It's already known that the F-35 can utilize its powerful ASA radar in electronic attack mode, degrading enemy radars. The F-47 will likely retain this ability to self-escort into hostile airspace by deploying a robust electronic warfare capability. And while we're discussing the new generation of electronics that'll go into the F-47, a peek at the engine it's expected to fly with can hint at some of the capabilities the plane's electronics will have. Right now, General Electric's Aerospace and Pratt & Whitney are in competition to figure out who will provide the engines for the F-47. Engines aren't just the thing that makes a plane fly. It's arguably one of the most important design elements, and the reason the U.S. has maintained a significant advantage over competitors. The fighter will feature a new generation of engine called adaptive cycle engines, which will allow the engine to physically transform in different flight regimes for enhanced operation. The engine can thus be configured mid-flight for increased performance or increased fuel efficiency, giving the F-47 great flexibility. Details on these new engines remain classified. However, years ago, General Electric revealed that its latest engine design, developed for the NGAD program, was already producing some impressive performance gains. It showed a 20% increase in thrust over the F-135 engine that currently powers the F-35, a 30% increase in range, 50% more loiter time, and perhaps most impressive of all, a 200% increase in cooling capacity. The cooling capacity of next-generation engines is of particular note, because the better you can manage engine heat, the more electricity that you can create. The F-47's engines are set to be the most powerful ever installed on a fighter, and it'll carry two of them, meaning it'll have the ability to generate serious amounts of electricity. And this is critical for next-generation electronics, which will inevitably feature power-hungry artificial intelligence capabilities. The F-47 will almost certainly include directed energy weapons in its bag of tricks. Lasers can provide an offensive punch at light speed, which would be perfect for dealing with drone swarms, but they can also be used offensively. A laser, for instance, could be used to generate a fake F-47 for heat-seeking missiles to home in on. Speaking of missiles, the F-47 is likely to be an absolute missile truck. This miniature stealth bomber will have a large weapons bay perfect for fielding next-generation air-to-air missiles, such as the AIM-260. This two-stage missile is the size of a small telephone pole, and it'll give the advantage back to U.S. forces after being outclassed by Chinese long-range air-to-air missiles. Given the need for flexibility in modern warfare, though, the F-47 will almost certainly take on the strike role as well, meaning it'll need room for air-to-ground weapons. The days of a pure fighter are well and truly over. The F-22 was originally imagined as being an air supremacy fighter until the budgetary realities forced the Air Force to quickly hammer some strike capabilities into the design. Many things remain shrouded in mystery about the F-47, but one thing that is a guarantee is that the aircraft will serve as the manned component of a manned/unmanned team. The F-47 will likely be a two-seat platform with a pilot and a weapons officer who will be primarily responsible for coordinating a flight of accompanying drones. How many drones? Well, there could be a lot of them. The Air Force has made a public declaration that it wishes to have 1,000 drones to accompany the F-47. But without knowing the drone-to-fighter ratio, there's no way of knowing how many drones each fighter will take to the sky. Experiments using single-seat F-35s have shown that thanks to advancements in AI, pilots are able to comfortably control 3 to 4 drones while still piloting their own aircraft. Thus, with a dedicated weapons officer being a strong likelihood, the F-47 will fly with more than this modest number. The big question, though, is what will all those drones do? So far, the Air Force has said that loyal wingmen will perform nearly every job that the base aircraft can do, but from a much more expendable platform. So, while the F-47 plays quarterback in the rear, drones flying well ahead of it could act in different roles. One would act as a sensor platform, using powerful passive and active sensors to scout for, identify, and track threats. It doesn't matter how stealthy your aircraft is designed to be, the moment that it starts blasting out high-energy radar waves, it's a matter of time before it's discovered. Another drone could be equipped with weapons, with its sole job being to act as the pointing stick part of the entire flight package. As a sensing drone identifies a target, it automatically assigns the weapons drone to engage it. A third drone, meanwhile, could be carrying out electronic warfare to confuse the enemy and degrade their own capabilities. It's basically taking the different capabilities of several different aircraft and putting them together into one integrated strike package. This approach also hints at the fact that the F-47 will not be available in very large numbers, unlike its drone wingmen. The Air Force has remained tight-lipped on this too, but it's believed that it wishes to purchase around 200 or so F-47s, putting it just above its purchase of the F-22. Combined with 1,000 loyal wingmen, it'll give the Air Force significant punching power in the sky, unless the entire design is inherently flawed. There's no way to know if the gamble will pay off, not until push comes to shove, because while it's no secret that the United States can build the most advanced fighter in the world, the real question is it building the right fighter? What do you think? Is the F-47 the future of air dominance, or a costly gamble the US might regret? Drop your thoughts in the comments. Now go check out 50 insane declassified FBI UFO secrets you didn't know, or click this other video instead.